New York City. Any detective worth his salt knows this is where the real work is. The stories, the danger. It's all happening here, 24/7. I, on the other hand, am currently located in a small Western Massachusetts town.
Oh, whoa.
Things don't move quite as fast around here. Matter of fact, sometimes things remain at a dead stop for weeks at a time. The name's Stone. Brett Stone. I make my living taking on surveillance gigs and taking down tough-talking crime syndicates. I keep my weapons in the freezer. I keep one loaded. The other keeps me loaded. For some strange reason, I have a deep affinity for all Billy Zane movies.
Phantom.
Some say that Kit Walker is the Phantom, but I know that I'm the ghost who walks. I'd recently lost a pretty penny betting on the old Bang Tails down at the track, so I'm currently a bit behind the eight ball. I needed a new case, and fast. These days, being a retro detective brings with it its fair share of cliches and tropes. Other than the excessive inner monologuing, I'm also constantly turning away various femme fatales who want me to take on their cases. It almost always results in the inevitable double-cross frame job. Damn these seductive beauties. But it comes with the job. Interesting.
All right, doll, let's start with you.
I need help with a box job so I don't end up in bracelets. Last Bruno that I swam with ended up with a Broderick put on him, so he's out of the game.
Look, I appreciate your commitment to the lingo, but let's back it up a little bit and rephrase that in English.
Please. I need help cracking a safe. Last guy that tried to do it got beat down and thrown in jail.
You see? So much clearer.
She was lying. Or she wasn't. I couldn't tell.
So this fellow you were involved with, it wouldn't happen to be Matt Malone, would it?
Yeah, you know him.
Most of us private dicks tend to belly up in the same bar now and again. So yeah, I knew him. He was always warning me about the bombshell dame that would come in trying to play the game, but not looking for the big win.
No, you have it all wrong.
No, you've got it all wrong if you think Brett Stone's gonna fall for a trap like that if he was dressed in a package just like you. So scram before you get blown down.
Well, that was something.
Yeah, in this line of work, you can tell the rabbits from the bunnies, you know?
And how exactly do you know I'm not here intent on springing the same fade?
I got a feeling, baby. And if I can't trust my gut, I can't trust nothing. So what do you got for me, Chippy?
My fiancé got in with some bad hatchet men. I think we might be in trouble. We need your help.
So why should I stick my neck out for you?
There's 50 large in it for you.
50 large? That's the kind of payday that'd make a guy not think twice, so I won't.
So where's this rube meet his
rats? He's not a rube. He's just a good man trying to provide for his family.
Hey, you don't need to sing me a song, baby. Just give me the facts and let me do what I do.
He works here. The Roscoes usually pop in around lunchtime to talk.
Wait, if you do stop in, I work there too, so you have to act like you don't know me.
Everybody's a stranger, baby. I tried stopping in at Sandy Harlow's office, but the place had been locked down for ages, it looked like. So I hightailed it out of there. I decided to stop by her residence, check out my payday.
What's the idea?
Hi, I'm the plant guy. I'm here to water the plants.
Water guy? I got business right now. Can you come back?
Your wife Sandra hired me.
Sandra.
And I gotta keep my schedule.
All right, come hang. Come on in. So the plants were over there. Johnny Harlow.
Waterman. Brett Waterman. Nice to meet you.
Name's Waterman and you water plants.
Well, I mean, you know, it's... I love plants.
Hey.
And water.
Hey. Well, fuck. Hey, Waterman. If you happen to see Sandra around, tell her to, you know, drop me a line. I've been looking for her.
What do you mean? You haven't talked to her in a while?
Something doesn't feel right. I can only hope my money is safe.
You know, I'll have to... Mr. Magenta! I didn't hear you come in.
Really appreciate your popping by here.
Do you now? Well, some people find my presence off-putting. Your enthusiasm seems a bit fabricated.
What? No, I'm pumped to see you right now.
This is the guy they're worried about? I was afraid I'd have to take on some larger-than-life bruiser with my karate.
Excuse me, Mr. Harlow. Do you have the paperwork for this order? Because I want to be sure I'm not overwatering or underwatering.
Hey! You keep your voice down when I have company here. You speak out of turn again, you'll be out on the street, you soak.
Yes, sir. Sorry, sir. Won't happen again.
Son of a bitch. Mister, Dick. Please don't.
Perhaps you should get the man what he requires. I respect a man who takes his charge to heart.
Oh, yeah, I was, you know, I'm just trying to... Okay.
You care for your babies, don't you?
I can tell. I care for mine as well.
Yeah, just trying to do the best job that I can, sir.
Yes, I admire that. You know, I could use a good waterman at my estate. Everyone could use a good waterman. Good confidant. What do you say?
I could use the extra money. When are we gonna do the... Should we set out like a sort of like idea of like a, something I could sign? Because I really could use that extra money from here.
Have a smell from the barrel. Good man.
Well, I am on the job, but that's when you should do it.
Why in God's name a botanist would need paperwork to know how to water a plant is beyond me, but I can't believe I have it. I do. Here you go. Must have stood up too fast.
I know our man here prostrate on the floor. You know I'm not here for his plants. You must know where his wife is. But I'll tell you. Where is? Where it goes. This damn poison is strong.
I think I can't smell a gumshoe. I wouldn't be very good at my job otherwise. Go to sleep now. Your friend over there, I gave him a much more concentrated dose. You know, I meant what I said when I said I respected you.
You had a date with his wife, Sandy. That canary. She could sing all night.
Must hold on. Must save the money and my beloved plants. I'm home? And I was recently cleaned and showered. Did that sicko have his way with me? I have to get back to the office. I think he touched my private eye. Big Mac, as he's known to his friends and enemies anyways. You end up owning a goon like this money, it's a short trip and a fall into a funeral.
Look what the queen's dragged in.
Hey, Big Mac. Hey, nice to see you. You know, I got some big payday coming, okay?
Now you owe me some money, and I need to see some green real soon, or I'm gonna start getting angry.
Just give me 24 hours, I promise.
You're lucky it's tea time.
Alright, look, I'm sorry that I'm not on time, as always, but... As you know, you can't get blood out of a stone.
Well, let's give it a go.
Hey, 24 hours, I said.
You have a 24-hour extension, or you lose your extension.
I see what you did there. Seamus O'Sullivan. One of those dickhead vice detectives. He's a nobody. Likes to pretend he's somebody.
Get your paws off me, O'Sullivan.
Listen, Sonny Jim, you're playing Parcheesi while the rest of us are playing Monopoly, and you're about to land on Park Place, and it's full of hotels and they ain't yours.
Take it from a guy that hates you, Stone.
If you want to keep rolling the dice, you better think about it long and hard, or getting out of jail for free is going to be the least of your worries.
I already got a double dose of the business, and I haven't even woken up yet.
Me and the boys at Vice are looking into Sandra Harlow.
Harlow?
You got a hot lead that you're the last one that was seen with her alive. What do you know about that, Stone?
It rings a bell, but I'll tell you, you should have seen the two bombshells I had in here the other day.
So I guess you know how Tojo felt in 45.
Woo!
Sandra Harlow, what do you know about her?
I don't know nothing about no Harlow.
I know that you know where Sandra Harlow was, and you're gonna tell me!
I know the kids out back got a sandbox, but ain't no Sandra.
The kids out back in their sandbox? You think that's what I'm here looking for? You think anyone gives a flying flip about the kids back in the sandbox? Sandy Harlow is dead! Maybe! Somewhere! And you're gonna tell me how we can find her? Look, Stone, if you had the sand to be an actual cop, you'd be one right now.
I know where I'm going. You know what? You don't even know when you're licked.
That's why you wash out of the academy. You would know better if you were there in 45.
What were you doing? Smoking tie stick and playing piano?
Yeah, I was smoking tie stick.
But I won't be caught dead next to a piano.
That's because you're always playing the wrong goddamn key. What the fuck is with you in this 45? You got some repressed memories or some shit?
Yeah, I was there in 45. I dropped the bombs. Something you'll never understand.
How's that important?
Yeah, I dropped both of those bombs.
How are you in two planes?
None of this getting us any closer to finding Sandy Harlow. And we got half a Ludlow Vice on the case. And if you get in the way, Stone.
Let me give you some advice about your vice. Get the fuck out of here.
Stone!
No way I was letting those vice punks know I had any intel on Sandy Harlow. This was my case, and nobody was getting between me and that sweet bread. I could only hope Magenta was keeping her alive. My 24 hours were running out fast. What's with the wild eye, Charlie? Some blind tiger jerking suds in the side?
I only pinch my hooch in fine establishments like the one you're drowning your sorrows in. Word on the street is you need info on Johnny Magenta.
How do you know what I would or wouldn't be interested in?
Word travels, buddy. Do you want the info or not?
Thrill me.
Not so fast. You gotta grease the wheels a little. I'm not independently wealthy. Magenta runs a pretty slick con. Pretends to offer up capital so he can get the lay of the land and run the place. Pretty slick with the ladies, though.
Hopefully that's not wasting my money. I need every penny I got right now.
He let the Harlow's business go under. Now apparently they both disappeared.
Hey, you guys ever seen Last Jedi?
Huh?
Last Jedi, Last Star Wars, you guys fucking seen it?
You mean Trek Wars?
Trek Wars? No. The new fucking Star Wars. You guys fucking like it?
Is this guy with you? Who the fuck is this guy?
We're talking business here. Okay.
All right. I guess you guys ain't fucking Star Wars guys then, huh?
Yeah, I guess not. Enough. Okay?
All right, guy. All right.
So, Star War? Star Wars?
Star Wars!
Hey, can I help you, Pug?
Just minding my business.
Private Dick don't take too kindly to some soak sitting by his drink. You're lucky you ain't packing iron. Where have you been?
I managed to slip away from Magenta last night. He fell asleep playing video games, and I managed to slip out of my cuffs. I'm laying low, changed up my appearance.
Are you okay? Everyone's been looking for you.
For the most part, he's just been feeding me grapes and making me listen to his spoken word poetry. God, it's awful.
You should count yourself lucky, Dollface, because from what I hear, that sicko's got even sicker appetites.
I need to leave town, maybe even the country. He's got eyes everywhere. I followed you from your apartment here, and that's when I decided it was time to make my move.
Look, Skirt, I got plenty of problems here to take care of before I go international. Is that what I think it is?
it's all of it. All 50 grand. Get me out of here safe and it's yours.
Wait. Stone, wouldn't happen to be Sandy Harlow,
would it?
Look, O'Sullivan, there's more going down than you know.
You're snowed if you're thinking you're leaving here with her, Stone. It's over.
Come with me if you want to live.
Cool, Terminator.
What the fuck? What the hell's going on? What is this, man?
You know, gotta say, really hate when my playthings escape before I've had the chance to play with them.
Magenta, I can smell you from around the corner.
You sick son of a bitch!
No one's here to debate whether or not I'm a sick son of a bitch. I'm a powerful son of a bitch. That affords me certain liberties. My associate. This is Mr. Killmonster. Arthur. Killmonster.
Wait, what's his last name? Killmonster?
Yeah. It's like a kid named Jeeves growing up to be a butler.
Sandy.
Listen, I know she meant a lot to you. I'm really sorry it had to come to this.
All right, look, guys. I know I'm way in over my head. This is my money, and I need it.
I'm sorry, what?
But when this is all done, you'll never see me again. Or the money.
Man, am I really tired of being knocked out. Although, this isn't much of an improvement.
So what do you think of the building? You know, as you travel around the city, you find buildings like this every once in a while, every few blocks. My family owns those. Wouldn't you say this is a great place to do business, detective?
I'm not complaining.
Hit him again, Artie!
So, this is how it ends. 2 feet away from all my problems ending. My sweet payday. I'm so sorry I let you down, baby. I should have worked harder for you.
You really needed that money, didn't you? Now it's pretty obvious that Sandy Harlow, she wasn't really part of the picture, was she? You know, detective, I'm really sorry that we ended up here. I really think, in another life, maybe we could have been friends. Hit him again, Art!
Yeah! Artie!
Now me! Me!
Sir?
Juicia! Oh. Hit me! Hit me! Something you should know about Arthur here, when we first met, I found he was raised by feral dogs.
I hated those dogs.
Yeah, no. So, already knows a thing or two about loyalty.
More like knowing the bone from behind.
Maybe once.
All right, Artie. Finish the job, give him the last little zap, and then it's the dinner specials for me and you at Ruby Tuesdays, my friend. Artie,
father?
No, wait, wait!
Imagine me with my head on your shoulder and you with your lips getting bolder. A sky full of moon and a sweet mellow tune. I'll buy that dream.
Look, I know I'm past the deadline, alright, but I stashed the money. These fucking guys are fucking after me, you gotta understand.
No excuses, no more lies. Time to pay the check.
Mac, you gotta believe me, get out of here. This guy's on his way over here.
No more stupid tricks, dude. Who's this?
You fuck! I warned you!
Let's dance, Puff.
You want to dance? Well, I want a polka.
Two birds, one stone.
Fuck!
Sorry. I don't even know you, but...
I didn't want to do this. I didn't want to have to kill you. I thought we could be friends. I really thought we could be friends.
Come on, man. What's it gonna take to end this?
You killed the only person I ever cared about.
What, that kill monster freak? Really?
One more kiss, motherfucker! Then it's night night forever!
Hello! I give a shit about him. Go ahead, kill him.
Oh, he'll die. They'll all die. Yeah, every fucking piece of shit you've ever diseased with your stench. I'll hunt them down and execute them.
So your grand plan is what? Have the cops come here, find all these bodies, and me dead?
Hey, you know. If it ain't broke.
It's a little cliche, but hey, at least I'll be remembered. Say, you wouldn't mind letting a private dick have one last swig of his old whiskey, would you?
Won't you pour two?
Oh, hey, Magenta, one more thing.
And what is that, Detective?
I've been writing the sequel down. Motherfucker, you're not in it.
Lasted longer than I would have thought, Stone. Took a shot to the head like a champ.
Who was that guy, Stone?
His name was John Magenta. And he hurt a pretty good friend of mine.
I might have been wrong about you, Stone. You might have what it takes. The Force could use you.
And give all this up? Pass.
What happened to that guy at the bar who Vulcan neck pinched me?
Killed him too.
Quite a little serial killer, aren't you, Stone?
Fucking A. Get the fuck out of here, Sully, before anyone sees us being friends.
You've had quite the evening.
Yeah, it was a rough one.
I woke up with a rope around my neck.
Is that you, Matt Malone? You son of a bitch.
Are you ready to talk to me now?